Broadcasting House, built in the 1930s, the iconic home of BBC. For years, music could be broadcast from London to the whole world from here. Yes, from London to the whole world. And now in this building, one of the greatest broadcasters the BBC has is making his show. Danny Baker knows about all kinds of London music.
Here we go.
But he's an expert on the last of the music hall artists, like Leslie Cerrone and Max Miller.
Oi!
How you getting on?
Oi!
How you getting on?
Good lavender cracking up, blimey!
You hear Mrs. Mippin remark?
I scrap and I rap and I do like a pap just to sit in as soon as it's dark.
Look at the coffin.
Coffin?
Blooming red handles.
Ain't it grand? To be blooming well dead.
There's so many great lines in this.
And look at me brother.
Blooming cigar on. Ain't it grand? To be blooming well dead.
Do you notice a follow-up? It's on here. Three cheers for the Undertaker as well. Three cheers for the Undertaker it is. Three cheers for the Undertaker. It's so funny.
Just as the title.
I know.
That is a great title. Three cheers for the Undertaker. That is.
Umpa, umpa, stick it up your jumper,
tra da 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 la la. It was a band by the BBC, Umpa, Umpa, Stick It Up Your Jumper. People say Umpa, Umpa, Stick It Up Your Jumper, but the original song, which is that, was the first song to get banned by the BBC.
But what
big
was,
Cockney song.
Because Umpa was like...
No, Stick It Up Your Jumper. You couldn't say things like that. No, Stick It Up Your Jumper.
You say you cannot sleep at night, your bed is no temptation. Say the word and marry me, and I'll be your salvation. I'll take your Horlicks up to bed and stop your night starvation.
Bring the band on! Bring the band on!
Yes! Oh, great! What joy! That's beautiful. You better get in and do your radio program.
I've got 10 minutes yet, and honestly, literally, there's no preparation, none.
You are capturing this on film.
No, that's all right. Everyone
We're
knows
capturing
it.
This on film.
It's
8 minutes, and you just couldn't care less.
Here I go, Chapman. I don't charge you, look. That's what's called a Piccadilly counter.
Whether it's a street trader, the people in the capital have always admired the verbal linguistic. Someone like Arthur English, the comedian, you know. I was in Trafalgar Square the other day, woman went down, Ace Jack King Queen on the deck. She come round, she said, where am I? I said, map of London, Lady Arthur Crown. Now that, you know, it's just ludicrous, but it's get as many words into that space as you can. Keep it moving, because I know you've got other things to do, because you live in London.
London music, earlier on you said to me, well, you didn't think there was such a thing.
I thought it was a specious concept, because I don't think you could ever hear a record and say, that sounds like a London record. So I think the idea of a London sound is too nebulous. You can't pin that down. A London rhythm. Yes, there's definitely a London rhythm.
And what is that London rhythm?
Attack.
In 1976, this noisy city gave birth to a new music once again. This time, punk.
Londoners are brash, extraordinarily confident, and it is a brash, confident city. Because London, you've got to get heard, and I do think is entirely related to traffic noise and just the populace and the noise of it. The ear thing Ian Dury adapted, which is as old as the hills, the oi, is literally be heard to someone over there.
Oi, oi!
Well, actually, the name's Dury, and I come from Upminster, and Allchurch, and Romford, and Walthamstow, and Harrow. And other places.
The impeccable attack of Ian Dury.
Just cause I ain't never had no nothing worth having, never, ever, never, ever.
Oi, oi.